Okay, for this tutorial, we'll explore the characteristics called the transconductance graph that relates the VGS value to the ID flow. The formula, as we saw in the Floyd textbook, says ID equals IDSS times 1 minus VGS over VGS off quantity squared. Here's the equation. For this circuit, which I'm simulating in MultiSim, we'll use a VCC of 5 volts and a VGG of minus 5, and we'll adjust that with a potentiometer so that the VGS value will step from 0 up to the maximum negative to cut the ID flow off. The first data step that we want to do is we want to put a short circuit across the VGS value by just running a wire from there to there. When I turn on the power switch for MultiSim, it does a calculation and we end up with 13 milliamps for ID. This will be the IDSS because the gate is shorted. IDSS is the current ID when VGS equals 0. As you can see, I've got a voltmeter measuring VGS and a voltmeter measuring VDS. If you measure VDS, you could always calculate the ID flow, because if this is 3.7 volts and this is 5, you just subtract the 2 and that's what's left across the 100 ohm resistor. Now I'll remove the short circuit and I'll start stepping the VGS voltage from 0 to a negative value by moving the pot from its 100% mark. First step, at 95%, you'll notice the VGS changed to 0.25 volts and notice the ID dropped to 11 milliamps. If I step it again, now the VGS is minus 0.5 volts and the ID dropped further. I'll step again, minus 0.75, it dropped further. And I'll keep stepping, and as you step enough down to 1.25 now, eventually the ID will cut off and stop flowing. And whatever that VGS value is at that point, that's called the VGS cutoff. I'm down to about minus 2, still some current flow, minus 2 1/4. And now we're down to 1 milliamp, and now it's dropping real fast, minus 3 volts for VGS, and minus 3 1/2. This is going to... Okay, now we're down to 9 microamps. We're certainly, I would consider that as zero current. So the VGS cutoff value was somewhere before the minus 3.75. Now what you want to do is step through those again and jot down the values for each step for minus VGS and ID, and we'll have created the transconductance graph, which should look like a decreasing parabola starting out at the IDSS value, and as ID drops down towards 0, the VGS goes out to its negative VGS point, and it should be a nice smooth curve. So try that again and jot those points down. Now in lab, if you were to actually build this circuit, we wouldn't have to use 5 volts for VCC. We could use something like 15, and instead of using a pot here, we could just vary the voltage on the power supply. But using LabVIEW in the circuit board, the circuit breakout box, we have to use 5 volts for that, and this minus 5. You'll also have to experiment with this 100 ohm resistor using LabVIEW. Once you get it working, you'll see that the curve is not a nice smooth parabola, and as you adjust the 100 ohm, try a 220 or maybe try a 330 or 470 until you get a nice smooth curve. Okay, that's all. Have fun.